I am someone who reads multiple books at the same time, depending on what I'm in the mood for. So I'm currently reading five books. It would be six, but I've decided that I have to cut myself off somewhere, otherwise it just gets ridiculous. I have a limit, apparently it's five. The book that I probably reach for most is The World of Jeeves by P.G. Wodehouse. It is a collection of Jeeves and Wooster short stories. They're easily digestible, they're set between the wars, and they follow the aristocratic Bertie Wooster and his valet Jeeves. I've been reading probably on average maybe one or two a day. It's just nice to dip in and out of, to have there. Bertie or one of his friends gets into some kind of trouble and Jeeves sort of gets him out of it in some way. Some of the stories do follow on from each other because they were in books, collections of books. So, but it's been a while since I've read them, so it's quite nice. It's like a refresher. I wouldn't be very true to myself or on brand if I wasn't reading some sort of historical fiction. And the second book that I have going is called Queen in the North, and it's by Anne O'Brien. The novel centers around Elizabeth Mortimer, who is the wife of Henry Hotspur Percy, if you like 15th century history, or Shakespeare, because he's in Henry IV, part one and part two. She's also the great granddaughter of Edward III, so she has royal blood. It's the war, the beginnings of the War of the Roses, essentially. The novel starts with the deposition of Richard II and the ascension of Henry IV, with which the Percys have quite a lot to do. They basically rule most of the North, hence the title. I love the War of the Roses. It's one of my favourite periods of history, and this particular rebellion incident is something that I don't actually know that much about. I won't spoil it because I'm only partway through anyway, but Elizabeth is in a position to tell this story through her point of view. I'm currently reading this as an ebook on my phone, which is why I keep forgetting about it. If you want a fun fact, Jane Seymour, who is Henry VIII's third wife, she is actually descended from Elizabeth Mortimer in the direct line. Probably wasn't interesting, but so my next book is Villette by Charlotte Bronte. Let me start by saying that I don't like Charlotte Bronte. I am biased and I'm admitting it. I first read Jane Eyre when I was about 14, which is probably, thinking back, is probably too young to appreciate everything that she was doing and all that kind of, yeah, things like that. My hope is that reading this will change my opinion of her as a writer, because I hear that Villette is better than Jane Eyre. So I have high, well, I have hopes. They're not particularly very high. I do feel bad basing my whole opinion of her writing on one book that I read and I didn't like. So my dislike of Charlotte herself comes from the way that she treated her sister Anne, because I love Anne Bronte, and The Tenant of Wildfell Hall was just this amazing, incredible, one of the first feminist novels. And she, after Anne died, Charlotte refused anyone to publish it. So we essentially lost that genius for such a long time. I could rant about this all day. And if you do want to know more about Anne and the Tenant of Wildfell Hall, I made a video on it, but I also produced a segment for Women's Hour when I was doing work experience there. And it was all about Anne and the Tenant of Wildfell Hall because it was the anniversary, it was a bicentenary of her birth, and that was in January. I'll put the link down there if you want to have a look. Anyway, I'm about 106 pages in, and I'm not in love yet. She has a tendency for writing really long sentences. I think some of them can be as long as a paragraph, so that's meh. I'm also not a huge fan of her anti-Catholic tendencies. It's just rude. And also she has this like moral and religious superiority, which it's annoying me. Her protagonist, Lucy Snow, is nice, if slightly inert character so far. She, where I am in the novel at the moment, she is working as an English teacher in a school in the town of Villette, and nothing's really happened yet. We'll see if I can reverse my bias. I mean, that's probably never gonna happen, but Virginia Woolf. It's the only nonfiction book that I'm reading at the moment, and it's two of her essays in a volume, which is A Room of One's Own and Three Guineas. I've read A Room of One's Own, which concerns women and fiction, and essentially the premise is that women need a room of one's own and money for them to be able to write fiction, and how that has been denied to them through the centuries by a patriarchal society and the subjugation of women. It's done very entertainingly and brilliantly, and it's not too heavy. It's just, she's got such an easy style to read, and she's an engaging writer. It's funny. There's no reason not to pick it up. Man, woman, it's just, I recommend it to everyone. I'm currently reading the second essay in it, which is Three Guineas. It talks about war, the relationship between education and war, how to avoid war, and very heavily talks about education, specifically higher education, university education, and women, and how that's been denied to them. And, you know, she makes excellent points. It's especially about the Victorian age and the establishment of the first women's college. I just love her. This is definitely going to be a jumping off point for me to read more of her fiction, although I know that some of her fiction is in a quite a poetic style, but I've not tried any of it. Apart from Orlando, I read a bit of Orlando when I was on a plane once, but I was so spectacularly ill afterwards that I just couldn't bear to pick it up again. But it's been a few years now, so I definitely want to try, because I know that that is about Vita Sackville West. She sort of like put her character into the character of Orlando. So, and I love Vita Sackville West. So that is, I'm very looking forward to that. The final book that I'm reading is Death by Disputation by Anna Castle. This is another historical fiction and another ebook, which again explains why I haven't finished it, because I don't have anywhere to go at the moment. It's a murder mystery, and it's the second book in her Francis Bacon series. Although Francis Bacon doesn't appear that much in this one. Oh, maybe he does, but later on, you know, I'm not too far into it. So our main character is Thomas Claridy, and he is studying at Cambridge University and reporting back to spymaster Francis Bacon. We're in the reign of Elizabeth I. Sorry, I didn't mention that. Tom's chief informer, he comes back and finds him hanging from the roof of his bedroom. And Christopher Marlowe, the poet and playwright that we know, and maybe love, I don't know. I haven't read any of his actually, now that I think about it. But he is the main suspect in the murder, and Tom has to figure out why he was murdered, and was it Christopher Marlowe, or who was it who actually murdered him? I like this book, but, you know, just like it. I had no real motivation to pick it up again. I don't know, I might have to just start it again completely at one point, or maybe just skip it and move to the next one. I don't know, I don't like doing that in a series. But when you've got a really good first book in the series, which it was Murder by Misrule, and that was just great, and I loved that and I enjoyed that and I got through it super fast on a few commutes, and this one just, I mean, I highly recommend that one. Do check that one out. And maybe it's just because it's been so long since I first read it, but I might struggle to finish this one. What a note to end on. So those are all the books that I'm currently reading and I want to finish before lockdown ends. I hope that you're enjoying whatever you're reading, and let me know what you're reading. Use the comments. This is weird. If you want to watch more of my videos, there's a red button which can really help you do that. What is happening to me? Happy reading.